All right, so for a test case management system to be considered useful to teams already performing continuous testing with automated tests, it needs to integrate automatically into the test suite. You need to eliminate the perception of manual data entry, or it will be considered burdensome overhead. This is because while test case management systems make a lot of sense when using them to organize manual tests and store their results, most continuous testing frameworks run their tests constantly and retain their pass-fail history already. So if you want the development teams to adopt the use of a test case management system without mutiny, you need to ensure results automatically carry over to the test case management system from the automated test suite. So in this video, I'll be showing you how to integrate NightwatchJS with TestRail so test results are posted automatically when the tests are run. All right, so to start off here, we need to grab our lesson files for today's tutorial. So that is under github.com/reallymellow under the Nightwatch tutorials directory. So we're going to go under code and copy the clone URL. And now inside our bash terminal, we can type in git clone and then put in our clone URL, bring that in. So now let's open up VS Code and open our folder. All right, we're going to be working out of the TestRail example folder, so let's expand that. And now let's open up the test folder and look at our example tests. So these are the same functional tests from a previous example, except now what we've done is added this update TestRail custom command, and that comes in from this nightwatch-testrail-updater npm package. And what that will allow us to do is send the test results into TestRail after each test finishes executing. Now to do that, you'll also notice that we have the browser.test ID at the top of the test, and this will associate your Nightwatch automated test with the IDs inside of TestRail. So now what we'll do is create these tests inside of TestRail and replace the IDs with the IDs that get generated there. So let's head over to TestRail, and you can see I already have one test case created, and you see the numeric ID here starting with a letter C. So we're gonna grab the numeric portion of that, and we're gonna replace the number here with that for this can see homepage test. So now these two are linked, and let's create the other remaining two tests, can navigate to software testing and can change page theme. So we'll replace can navigate to software testing's ID here with that one. All right, and lastly, let's grab this one for can change page theme. So now that the IDs are associated, we need to create a test run. So let's go over test runs and results and click on add test run. Call this one tutorial run and choose to select specific cases. Let's change our selection and grab the tutorials tests. All right, let's add that test run. All right, now at the top left here, you'll see that the tutorial run has a run ID as well. So we're going to copy that and go back over to our test project and now open up nightwatch.json. And down under test settings, you'll notice under globals, you have TestRail here with a host and a run ID. So we're going to replace the run ID with that value that we just grabbed out of TestRail. And then here under host, replace the host with your actual installed deployment of TestRail. So now that we have the host and run ID filled out, I want to direct your attention here up to the top under custom commands path. This is where the Nightwatch TestRail updater command comes in. And lastly, so that you can authenticate with your TestRail instance, you need to create two environment variables, one called TestRail username that holds your TestRail username, and the other one is your TestRail API key. And by keeping them as environment variables, you don't run the risk of accidentally checking these in with your source code. So off screen, I've already set these two values inside my bash profile. All right, so now all we need to do is launch a terminal. Let's navigate to the TestRail example folder, type in npm install. That should bring in our packages. And if everything worked correctly, I should just be able to type Nightwatch. First test ran. Here goes our second test. And lastly, our third test. And if you look at the command output down here, you can see that the test result was successfully posted to TestRail. So now let's go back to Chrome and look at our test run. So before I refresh the page, let's take a look at our test run. So you can see all three tests show as untested. So now let's refresh our page. Now we have a totally green pie, 100% passed. You can see that the tests themselves indicate passed if we drill into them. You can see the last runtime as well as the output of the test execution that was shown in the terminal. So this was a simple one with only one step, and the last one had a few. So here you can take a look. This one had three steps. They're all indicated here. And what's going to happen as you continually execute these tests is that they're going to build up a nice little history here, which is nice to see over time. You can see the reliability of the test. If you see a bunch of passes, then all of a sudden a fail. You know, you might have found a defect with the latest code check-in. Let's run this again and see that in action. So if I refresh this, I should see another test run. And there you go. So now your automate tests just kind of come in here automatically. You can add manual tests to the same suite, and those can be executed on a different schedule, but all the nice history is kept in one central place, so it's great for auditing and other things like that. All right, so before you go, let me know how you liked the video by clicking on that like button. Please subscribe and reach out in the comments section if you have any questions, and thanks for watching.